Like, welcome back to Mountain Bike Adrenaline.
Yeah.
This time we're going on to the second of four areas, the Alps.
Yeah.
Which you're going to see pretty much just looks like the Rockies, but with a little bit more rocks everywhere. Not even snow. It's just rocks everywhere.
I haven't been to the Alps, so I have no idea what it's like. And I haven't looked at any pictures.
Well, when I think of the Alps, recently,
but I think of snow.
Yeah, when I think of the Alps, I think of the Swiss Alps, and
yeah,
you know, Swiss
yeah.
Alps, Swiss Miss, you know, all that. That's got, you know, snow in it, not rocks all over the place and such. But so we got a new rider who is straight
just
up
better. Yeah.
So. Let's not pick him. I mean, let's definitely pick him, yeah. But let's not keep with Alex. You know? So
fuck Alex.
I'm guessing the rest of the characters are just straight up upgrades until we get to the generic, like, full stats character.
Right. Skier X.
Which, you know, I guess is better than the default character being better than everyone else, but...
Right. Johnny Mosley. He's just better than everybody.
But, you know, at least I could still hope for them to do something where, you know, the characters have their stats going all over the place. And
right.
I guess that's snow, but... So these rocks... All these rocks, if you have vibration on, your controller rumbles the entire time you're on the rocks. And, like, definitely later on, especially in the challenge events, they, like, slow you down a whole lot. And you might not be able to notice it so
yeah,
well
time,
in the video.
At that
but
time, it did look like you just slowed down.
Just
nearly a
slow crawl. Down, rumbling shit, and the rocks fucking crash you later. Like, I've got a good kind of montage of that.
Oh, good.
Going, but the racing events in the Alps are pretty kind of painless. And actually, I think this area is actually pretty small compared to like the Rockies one. They recycle pretty much just one area. Whereas,
that's good.
Whereas the Rockies area, there was at least sort of three sections if you weren't really paying attention.
Yeah.
There were three or four paths
that they used. Oh god!
Oh yeah,
what the
these
hell?
Are. I call these the shores of slowdown or the shores of stuttering.
Oh my god, that was beautiful.
Cause yeah, the game's just like blah, 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 blah,
wait,
blah.
Wait, what do you want to do?
I guess you know the one positive I could say is that the game has all right water physics, or not really physics, but all right looking water. Like it doesn't look superly like a sack of shit.
Right, like I didn't take a good look at it. I'll look at it next time we're near water.
Yeah, next time we get down there.
Oh,
in
do
this
we get...
race.
Oh, okay, good.
I think all the yeah, all the
oh,
races.
Oh, look at that slow down. Stuttering and it doesn't know what
but,
you're doing.
Yeah, especially right here I'm having a super tough time getting across the rocks and such. And I just want to be free, you know. I want to break free of those confinement of that confinement, and I just want to go all out, and I just want to, you know, go full speed down some sick slopes. You know, I still want to go off of a jump and pull like a quadruple backflip, like 9 million spins.
Jesus.
Like
okay,
awesome,
quadruple
awesome
okay.
Grab trick,
but you can't do that in
yeah,
this
I'm
game.
Not gonna
yeah that water doesn't look bad
yeah
it doesn't look like incredible or super realistic or anything, but for its time, it doesn't look too bad.
Yeah, I mean, that's like the one thing that certainly says, well, by 2007, they got something right.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But at least all those.
I'm yawning because this game is boring.
Because you're really tired at like 8:30 at night for some reason.
Yeah, I didn't get a lot of sleep last night.
Were you dreaming or having nightmares about Mountain Bike Adrenaline?
No, I had this really weird dream where my brother Dave and I, for some reason, were hired as a team of assassins to hunt down Richard Dawkins and Wayne Brady. I shit All right. you not. They were bros, apparently. Oh, God!
The shores of slowdown extend to any point where there's water.
Right, yeah.
But, alright, just wanted to make sure that you weren't waking up in a cold sweat watching my guy wheelie across thin wooden beams.
No.
I gotta say, at least those are...
I haven't started having those nightmares yet.
At least those are mostly gone from this level. Like, you see, this collect-a-thon is literally just me riding in a bunch of other places.
Yeah. This is... Ugh, look at that. Like, so you've kind of learned how the controls
how the controls work and how the gears work. You know, I actually, as a kid, I had a bike which had 13 gears on it. Like, the handlebar had 13 things you could switch between.
I don't know if that's
between.
A lot, but it sounds like a lot.
I think it was a lot.
Because I think I had a bike that had 6.
And
so.
I never really could notice the difference between them. Then again, I didn't ride on anything but, like, sidewalks.
Right.
You know, I never went mountain bike adrenaline-ing.
Yeah, or hill bike boredoming.
Hill bike boredoming. I guess maybe I coasted up a couple small hills in my time, but never something like this.
Yeah.
So,
I mean, we live in pretty flat areas.
Yeah, but...
So
the lower the gear, from what Alan explained to me, the lower the gear, the, I think he actually explained it the other way. Like, at the higher gears, you're putting more, higher gears are best for, like, natural grassy stuff, and lower gears are best for, like, rocks and shit that it's really tough to go on.
Okay.
So, like, down gear shift when you've got that stuff, and it'll make your life a little easier. And then, especially, again, you'll see in the challenges, like, go to the top gear when you're riding down a big grassy thing, and you'll somehow get more speed.
I don't know how it works.
Yeah, but because this is, like, rocky hell. Also, the default gear switching controls are set on semi-auto, which I don't really know how you do that for, like, shifting gears.
I understand how that works for a gun,
yeah.
But that's a very different sort of mechanic, and they mean something very different that... What?
wait.
What?
I don't know. I don't know.
That's beautiful.
Yeah.
I love that.
I've also got something very special that I recorded in the next video as well.
Oh, good. Good.
I'm not going to spoil it until then. But
good.
I don't know how this stuff happens to me while I record. I mean, sure, I experience minutes of
I feel like
hateful.
This game is forcing you into concentration mode. When you get to the beaches, because it's just so confused. It's like he has to be
The shores of slowdown.
Yeah. The shores of slowdown.
Yeah.
71% of the way through.
Yeah. So you were right last episode. Like, there's 7 events here, so the game wasn't even consistent about
really?
The same amount of events.
That's good. I like that.
You know, I'm guessing 2 of the 4 levels have 6 events, 2 of the 4 levels have 7.
I was thinking it was going to be like a 6, a 7, and then like 2 4s.
like
they just gave up.
The game just had to cram one more race inside of these stopwatch events. One more race. You see how, you know, we're using the same exact area each time?
Yeah.
Going to the same exact places, pretty much taking almost the same exact paths.
Yeah.
Like, again, at least with the Rockies, you
there
know,
was a little bit of variation.
If you kind of
take things
turned your brain off, you know,
you wouldn't notice it.
Yeah. You wouldn't notice it as much. What was I even going to talk about?
Well, you turned your brain off while trying to think of what you needed to say, and
oh, yeah. The game felt like it just had to cram one more race in there, where I start at the top of this mound of rocks, and then I glide down the mound of rocks.
You just had to start at the top of a sack of dicks.
At least, this wasn't all that painful to do, you know?
Yeah.
At least it was fairly painless. Again, unlike the challenge mode video, which I'm going to be like pretty much bitching nonstop on just one.
See, I think I should explain something to the viewers, and maybe you won't appreciate me explaining this, but since I live with Insetic, I get to hear I get to see what he's like during different moods. And one of the, like, I think it was JetX2O, you were having a lot of trouble on one or two videos or something. On a couple games, this has happened. And sometimes he gets so mad, he shouts. You know, he gets pissed off and he goes, "Oh my god!" And I can hear him from the other room, not because he's really loud, but because the walls are really thin. And then this game managed to make him so mad that he was just, like, dead quiet. Like, normally I can hear the controller and, like, the little clicking and clacking from the back. No, I couldn't hear a thing. And I thought he died. And so I went back there just thinking, like, is he dead? Maybe I should check to see if I can loot his stuff. And he's just sitting there, and I see him, like, with the computer open. He's recording or whatever. And I'm like, you recording? And you're like, he's like, yeah. And he's just playing. And I'm just like, is it going well? No, not at all. Is it really giving you trouble? Yeah. Yeah, I hate this thing. I don't even know what the fuck they want me to do.
Yeah, I think that, like, I think then, like, you turned and looked at the TV and I was trying something for 5 minutes straight.
Yeah, yeah. It was like
you walked on me while
it was just so...
You walked on me while I was playing this the first time. Yeah. Like, these levels the first time. And then you walked in on me while I was recording, and I was at the same event both times.
Yeah.
And I was having the same amount of trouble both times.
It was just... Yeah, we're halfway through Stopwatch! Woo!
I gotta be honest, I haven't played Hawaii yet. I'm actually looking forward to it. All I can imagine is that I'm, like, riding across narrow beams over, like, rivers of lava.
Yep.
And that almost sounds fun.
Almost. The only way I can see that looking really fun is if your guy, like, falls into lava and then just, like, you see him, like, explode in flame and he, like, goes down under the surface of the lava.
If there's, like, a death animation for falling into lava, that's gonna be so dumb.
I would give this game mad props.
Mad props?
Mad props.
I would give it maybe one...
Furious props.
I would give it maybe one more prop.
Yeah.
I would bump this game...
Well, one furious prop.
I would bump this game's score up from a 0 out of 10 to a 1 out of 10.
I would bump it up to maybe a 0.5 out of 10.
Yeah, maybe.
I mean, one furious 0.5. Yeah. Just...
0.5 out of 10!
Yeah.
Just slam your fist down on the
table. I'm not going to break your table.
Yeah, it's okay.
Yeah, he has a really cool table.
Uh-huh.
It's like glass and space age, and it's like a spaceship.
Space age technology. You know, this was the table that NASA used when they sent their astronauts.
This was actually the prop from what's it called? 2001.
Space Odyssey.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. This is the actual
ship. That table.
Yeah,
the ship.
Yeah, this is
okay,
the ship.
Sure.
Yeah, that they used.
So that was Stopwatch event. Hope that, you know, that wasn't too bad.
Yeah, yeah. No, hopefully
that wasn't too bad.
Hopefully the challenge mode is entertaining for you guys, because I'm sure it wasn't entertaining for you.
I'm gonna have amazing facts to bring up at the very start of that next video.
Question: have you started having nightmares about this game yet?
Yes.
Okay, just making sure.
All right, see you next time. Bye.